Hi everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk, and today I want to go through an important video as I always do on all devices, and today is looking at the accessibility side on the Honor 8X. So first of all, there is an option that you can always use with every device that's preset into the device. So without going through the settings, you can press both the volume keys here at the side. While pressing both volume keys for about 5 seconds, this message will pop up and it will allow Talkback on your device right from the beginning. And Talkback is a great feature, and I want to show you more accessible options that you have on your device, including Talkback. So to get into your settings normally, what you need to do is tap the settings icon. So the first couple of options are in a different place. So if we go into display, which is here, then you have text size. So text size is set on huge so I can read it. You then have view mode here. So in view mode, you can change and adjust the view of your display, making it larger. And as you can see, that will change and adjust in the applications here. So coming back, scrolling all the way down to the bottom, you're actually going to find Smart Assistant. That's three from bottom, and this is where it's going to show you all your accessibility settings. So inside here you have accessibility, so let's go into here. So starting off at the top is Talkback. So Talkback is a great feature. Like I said, it's preset in there for a quick accessible shortcut option. So if we toggle this on, so with Talkback it's going to discuss everything that is on your screen and read it all back to you. So let me show you now.
When Talkback is on, it provides spoken feedback so that you can use your device without looking at the screen. This can be helpful for people who are blind or have low vision.
So as it discussed, it will talk back everything to you. You can also highlight anything on your device wherever you are, no matter it being home screen, the taskbar, or a standard screen. It will read back everything to you. So I can highlight Vodafone here in the top corner.
Vodafone UK, Talkback, 47%, NFC enabled, 1117.
So it will talk back everything to me. In a menu option, tap once to highlight.
Navigate up, accessibility.
And then what you do with two fingers is scroll up and down the display, and you'll hear a pitch tone going up and down. So that is the Talkback feature here, one of the best features on a smartphone. With the power and performance built into the Honor 8X, it runs really well, really smooth with emails and also on the internet browser as well. There is another option which is called Select to Speak. We're going to toggle this on. So once this is toggled on, you're going to get a fourth icon down here at the bottom, which is a little accessibility man. And if I hit play,
Select to Speak, help. When Select to Speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them read aloud.
So it will read everything for you. If I press stop, and if I press it again, and then I touch somewhere else, it will actually read that first.
Select to Speak.
So it will only talk back the thing that I've actually highlighted, which is a great option. Again, works throughout the device. Underneath that is Switch Access. This gives you the ability to use switches to use and manipulate your device if you can't with your hands. It's a great option and it's really good to see there. Then you're coming into Captions. Captions will caption what's on your display for you and give you subtitles. Underneath that is Magnification Gesture. So if we turn this on, 1, 2, 3. Three quick taps with a single finger will zoom into your display. You can use a pinch to zoom option as well, and you can then navigate around your display here. As it is a large display, you're going to see a lot of content. 1, 2, 3 to come back. Then once you do it again, if you hold on the third tap with one finger here, you can see I'm in and moving around with one finger, but as soon as I let go, it zooms back out. You then have click after cursor stops moving, so you can use a mouse cursor with this one. You've got high contrast text as it's toggled on. You'll see a difference here. The power button that's down the right hand side will end your calls. You have speak your password. Large mouse pointer is also available. You have mono audio. Accessibility shortcut, like I discussed at the beginning, which is preset to Talkback. Then you have text-to-speech output. So this is where you can change your pitch and your speed when your device is talking back to you. You have touch and hold delay here for dexterity and input issues, so it helps you with your device. You have color inversion. So with this, it's going to give you white text on a black background, but when on the home screen here, it's going to really change all of the colors. So please only use that when you need it, maybe in the menu options. Then you also have color correction here for people that suffer with missing the right colors. You can change and adjust your display to change and make it better for you. So that is the accessibility option there. And there are loads of different options inside here from multiple range of disabilities, making this device possible to use for people with severe disabilities, or even if they just need a single little helping hand somewhere with magnification, with hearing options, options, it's all on here. Coming under accessibility is a smart shopping option from High Touch. So what this does is uses Amazon UK, and you can use this in the camera application, or you can press and hold on an image to see what is available at Amazon UK. So let's test that out now. So I've got the camera open. Let's test it out on this little Lego figure here. So it'll load up Amazon UK. It's going to see if it can find relevant information, and it has done. It's given Lego product, which is really good. It recognizes the Lego figure and gives me Lego products to then go and buy on Amazon UK. It is only linked to Amazon UK, but if you do shop on Amazon UK, it's going to be worthwhile. There is another option you can use High Touch for, and that's with a photograph. So with a photograph, press two fingers on the display. You're going to get the shimmer and shine, and then it should recognize this. Again, it's going to load the Amazon UK store. The app actually does need to be installed as well. So here we go. It's found Call of Duty's Black Ops 4. That's correct. That's what the image was, and it's given me relevant information and products. So that's a great feature there, and I do recommend using that as well to just get the best possible use out of your smart shopping experience. So underneath High Touch there, you've got one hand UI. So once toggled on, let's go into one hand UI, you've got a mini screen view here. So if you swipe from left to right or right to left, you're going to have a mini screen view here that you can use with one hand UI, which is great. So you can get around with one hand, and you can jump around your device. Tapping will turn this away. Then also underneath, you have a shifting keyboard option. Again, once toggled on, the keyboard can shift left to right depending on what hand you're using your device. Underneath that, you then have motion control. So you have flip, and this will mute your device. You have pick up to reduce ringing volume or wake your device. You then have raise up to answer or make calls, or then control the speaker or Bluetooth headset connected to your device. Then you have three finger screenshot. So if we go inside here, toggle this on with three fingers down the display, you can take a screenshot, you can edit this and then send it away, whatever you need to do with it. Again, great option to have here. Underneath that, you've got touch disable mode. This is where it's going to try and identify when the device is accidentally touched and won't actually make any actions come true. Then also you have scheduled power on and off options there as well. So coming back home, there is a great array of settings on here for accessibility, which is always great to see. At the very beginning as well, when you're setting up your device, you have a range of accessibility options that I showed in the unboxing video. It's nice to see that there are so many options on here as well. So if you do have any questions or queries, please drop a comment down below and I'll be more than happy to help. Please give the video a like and remember to subscribe and ring the notification bell to stay updated with all my latest videos. From me, Ricky, I'll see you very soon. Bye for now.